Hello, Aries. This is Carrie from Celestial Forecasts with your bonus reading for the first half of May. Thank you so very much for tuning in. We're going to be focusing on, initially for your focus messages, mind, body, and soul. I did a reading recently where I did focus on that, and I really wanted to do that same concept for the focus messages this time around for the bonus readings. So that's what we're going to be tapping into initially. General reading, as always, Aries, it's not going to resonate with every single person. So please do take from this whatever makes sense for you and let the rest go. If you're interested in your own personal private reading, all of that information is down below in the description box. And I will also have a link to all of the card decks that are used here today. So let's dive right into it. The three card decks that I chose for Mind, Body, and Soul: The Untold Messages of the Heart by Aqua Moonlight. This is a brand new deck by Angelic Revelation 144. It's called Twin Flames Astral Intimacy Oracle, and then Divine Essentials Counterparts Oracle. All right, guys, so let me set these guys aside first, and let's go ahead and take a look at the mind. What is your person thinking when it comes to you? This could be what you're thinking too. You know, it could be tapped into your mind as well. Angels and spirit guides for Aries. What is it that you need to focus on at this time? All right. Guided to this one. Home. You're the missing puzzle piece that makes me feel that I'm right where I belong. This is what they're thinking. This is what they're focused on when it comes to you in their mind space. Aries, you feel like home to this person. You could resonate with that card as well for the person that you're focused on for this reading. So let's take a look at the body. Now, mind you guys, this can contain profanity and definitely sexual content. So please do keep that in mind. Angels and spirit guides for Aries. When it comes to the mind, when it comes to the physical connection here, what needs to come through? What is the focus energies for the body, the intimacy, the physical? All right, I'm guided to this one here. Baby making sex. So if you guys have thought about building a family, having children someday, that's certainly being indicated right there. And some of you guys might have already had children together, and perhaps this person wants to have more children with you. There you go. It's reflected right there in the body energy, the physical. All right, the soul aspect of things when it comes to your connection. Aries, let's take a look at that. So we've got the mind, we've got the body. Now here is the soul. All right. I'm immediately guided to this one here. We both have wounds we need to heal. So during this time, you guys might be, I'm feeling, going through certain challenges in your relationship, having gone through something difficult in the partnership, there's healing that's needed here. So let's dive right into it. Let's take a look and see what went down and what it is that you guys need to heal from. So let's grab some insight from the Illumination deck here. This is by Lightworker Tarot and Oracle. Angels and spirit guides for Aries for this bonus reading for whoever needs it. What does spirit need you to know, Aries, at this time? For this bonus reading, life partner. Wow. This is somebody that either is already your life partner and you guys are having issues right now, or you're in separation, you're not together, but you still consider this person your life partner, or they as well could think of you in this way. And going back to this very first message, tapped into the mind's energy, you feel like home. You're the missing puzzle piece that makes them feel that they're right where they belong. And perhaps you resonate with that for yourself too. And this is how you feel about this person. We have embrace change coming through as well. So the way things were going before wasn't working. Something went wrong there. which is why healing is needed here. Changes need to be implemented in this connection. We do have receiving a message right after that. So if you haven't heard from them in a while, if communication just hasn't been flowing between the two of you, you might actually hear from this person, either a text or a phone call, some form of communication, or certainly the desire to reach out to you is here. The next card is spend some time together. So if you guys have been estranged, if you haven't been spending a whole lot of time together, you might actually hear from them to spend this quality time together to address the issues. We do have, it's over, you know. This could certainly have been what happened, that you guys called it quits. And you spent a good chunk of your life with this person, perhaps. But there are changes that need to happen here in order for you guys to come back together. Clearly, they're still thinking about you. That mind, body, and soul energy doesn't equate to me that it's over. So if you guys are in separation, perhaps that's why this is coming through. But based off of the surrounding energies and the cards, they still want to reach out. They want to be able to spend time with you still. They feel like home when they are with you, Aries. That's what I'm picking up from that. So let's see. Let's see what else needs to come through here with the Mystic Moon Oracles. Angels and Spirit Guides for Aries. For this bonus reading for whoever needs it right now. What does Spirit need you to know when it comes to this person? We do have the Tribe coming through. This is family right here. People that have your back and the people that you know are there for you no matter what. And baby making sex, you know, they want to be able to build a tribe with you if you don't already have one. And if it really is over, or at least you guys had that agreement that you were going to go your separate ways, they're still checking you out from a distance. So they haven't really detached from you. They're still keeping tabs on you, Aries. And maybe if you follow each other on social media, maybe you know that anyway. Clearly they want to reach out. Receiving a message is right there. And maybe they're just a little bit hesitant. Maybe they're afraid to reach out for whatever reason. We've got union right after that. This is telling me here. For one thing, they want you back. They want to come back into union with you. It's not over. They want to be able to reach out. They want to be able to talk. They want to be able to see you and spend quality time with you. They want to be able to work on this partnership and heal whatever wounds have been created as a result of whatever happened between the two of you. We do have action. Right next to union, falling right below spend some time together. So I feel here your person, part of the action that they're going to be taking towards you is to simply reach out, to get the conversation flowing, to get it started once again, to figure things out here. Now, for some of you, this could have been why it's falling right below, it's over. Because of this third party. Or the added interpretation of this is that the third party, that element of this, is a done deal. So they're now ready to be able to communicate with you again, to reach out, to repair the damage, to heal the wounds. They want to come home, especially if you guys had a home together. They want those intimate moments with you once again to build that tribe. And to just be intimate with you once again. we also have awakening coming through. So for my masculines, we have a masculine figure in that photo. It is just energy though, so it could be male or female, whoever's resonating with this message. Somebody went through their awakening process. Realizations, that aha moment, that wake-up call to do the right thing, to take action, to remove themselves from this third party, if that was indeed part of the reason why you guys fell apart. And I feel for those of you resonating with this, that was part of the issue. That was definitely part of the issue. So let's add some insight to this with some tarot. This is the Twin Flame Journey Tarot by Mystic Moon. Angels and Spirit Guides for Aries for this bonus reading for whoever needs it at this time. Yeah, Ten of Swords is a painful ending. That's air energy, Libra, Aquarius, Gemini. This life partner, this life partnership that you guys had once shared, painfully ended because more than likely there was a third party involvement here. Lots of hurt feelings, lots of angry words. So I'm not surprised to see this. We both have wounds. We need to heal. But we do have the Nine of Cups here. This is satisfaction and wish fulfillment. So when it comes to this connection, Aries, if you still see a part of yourself wanting to reconnect with this person, wanting to start over, bring the connection back together, because ultimately you feel as well like they are home to you. You share a home, you shared a life. They are your wish come true. An added interpretation of the Nine of Cups, though, is somebody who drinks too much. So that could have been part of the issue, too, if somebody had that issue going on. That could have been the third-party element here, because it doesn't always have to be infidelity. It doesn't always have to be cheating that's involved in a partnership to fall apart. And if somebody has had an addiction or alcoholism or however way that was presenting itself, whatever problem drove a wedge between the two of you, that could have been a problem too. We do have the Queen of Swords. So for my feminines, you're coming through as this queen, somebody who's very sharp, somebody who's very assertive, somebody who can be a little bit guarded at times, which is understandable considering what's gone down here. You know, you're not afraid to stand up for yourself. You're not afraid to speak your mind, and you're definitely not going to take shit from anybody, especially this person, if they allowed themselves to get involved in a third party situation. So it could have been my feminines who cut the masculine out, if it is indeed the masculine who entered into this situation with somebody else. We have a Knight of Wands coming through here. That is fire energy, Aries, which of course is your own vibe. So this does indicate a passionate adventure. The Knight of Wands, they have the mentality of, you know, you only live once, so you might as well be fearless and do what it is that you love. But if that includes third-party situations, that has created drama in the dynamic of this relationship. And if it was you, Aries, that got yourself involved in a third party, sure, it could have been great at the time that you were in it, very passionate sexual interactions with this individual, but I just ultimately feel they weren't able to offer you anything more than that, when in fact you've got this life partner here that you shared a home with, perhaps, or even a family, had dreams of building one, and certainly picturing a future with this person long term. And then here comes this third party element that just drove a wedge between the two of you. So it's quite fitting how we've got the tower falling right below that, because this third party brought this tower down. on this situation. And the Tower is fire energy, which of course, Aries, that's your own vibe right there. So it is part of the interpretation here that some of you guys were involved with a third party, or you were highly affected by this situation and that Tower came down on you and the relationship, and that it was unexpected and it was chaotic and it was very traumatic. It was not an easy thing to go through. And Towers are indicative of financial issues. Money could have been an issue here. Separations for sure. We did start off with life partner there, and so some of you guys could have been married to this person. So it's a marriage that fell apart, basically, because of a third party situation. Some of you guys might have even contemplated divorce or actually went through with it. And some of my feminines, you had to cut this person out of your life because they were in a situation where there was distrust and deception and third parties and infidelity. But this hurt a lot. But what I'm ultimately feeling here is that there's this desire to work on the partnership, that this third party element is over, that the Tower came crashing down on it, and it's no longer a part of the equation here between the two of you. So now you can focus on healing. You can focus on repairing the damage that was caused by this destruction of this third party. So we've got the King of Cups coming through now, okay? If they were coming through as the Knight before, my masculines are now coming through as the King. So I feel there's work that the masculine has done here in order to be able to come towards this Queen with this Cup of Love, having grown from the experience, having learned from the experience, truly wanting to fix what's broken between the two of you. They want to be able to make your wish come true still, to bring back the happy times, to bring this union back together. Because without the other, perhaps you guys just feel incomplete. As that message states, you're the missing puzzle piece. Without each other, that puzzle is incomplete. Okay? So let's add some romance angels to this. Angels and spirit guides, please, for Aries, for this bonus reading, for whoever needs it. What else does spirit need you to know right now? We already know there's third-party involvements. And it's time for you to love yourself first at this time. Your self-respect makes you more romantically attractive. Your person has to do this too. That's part of the healing journey. Express your love. Go ahead and make the romantic gesture. And I feel this King, when the time is right, will be able to do that, to be able to offer the feminine, this Queen, that cup of love and just say it. It's like, what's he saying? What's in his heart space? And the love, I feel, it's still there. You guys have definitely have been through some challenges. You don't go through this Ten of Swords and not feel it. It's very painful energy. Broken heart. But this person ultimately could be your true love here, Aries. This is the romance of a lifetime. Healing family issues. I'm not surprised to be seeing this because we do have the Tribe represented here and the reference to baby making sex over here. So this person wants to repair the damage in this partnership, to build a life with you, to have a family with you, to start that family for those of you who have yet to have children together. And then there are those of you who already have children or blended families, and maybe you want to have a child of your own to add to the tribe, you know, however way that is. But the family dynamic has been torn apart as a result of this tower moment. Especially for those of you who already have children, whether young children, school-age kids, or even adult kids, it doesn't matter. They were affected by this as well. And they are a part of the healing that needs to happen here. They're a part of it. Okay, so let's grab some dialogue messages here to tap into this. Okay, here we are. This is one of my favorite decks lately for dialogue messages. This is the You Have My Heart, Soul Lovers in Separation by Angelic Revelation 144. Check out her channel if you haven't already. She's got a bunch of amazing card decks that she's created. So if you're a reader too, definitely. If you don't know about her, check it out. Okay. Let's take a look and see what your person has to say. You might even resonate with some of these messages for yourself, Aries, and what it is that you feel the need to say to your person. So we'll pull a few from here. Take whichever one you're guided towards, as always. We'll grab some more. All right, let's grab the bottom card. All right. What is it that your person has to say to you? First one. Oh my gosh. Okay. I am involved with someone else, and it wouldn't be fair to either of you to pursue our connection at this time. Okay. So for some of you guys, and I don't feel this for a whole lot of you. I just feel for some of you, your person who's in this third party, they're still in it, which is why it is falling right next to that it's over card. And then we've got the tower right next to it. So there are those of you who perhaps have chosen to detach from this person because they are still involved with somebody else. I just feel here too from this person that even though they might still be with this third party, a part of their heart is still attached to you somehow. But you know, by the time they get their act together, you might not even want them. So that's their issue, right? It takes two people to put in the effort to save a relationship. And if they are not putting in that effort, then more than likely, that's why you've cut them out of your life. And that's totally understandable. Next message. I only want two things in life. Everything that makes you happy and nothing that makes you suffer. I love you always and forever. First of all, they've already contributed to the suffering. They've already contributed to hurting you. And I feel with distance, with time, with this awakening journey that they've been on, they've had some realizations here as to how much you ultimately do mean to them and what it is that they need to do to take action, to express their love, to heal whatever needs healing between the two of you. Next message. Your love makes me feel untouchable and invincible. You make me stronger, happier, and wiser. Your love is the greatest love I have ever known. And lately, what I've been feeling is that two people that have gone through something painful, something very challenging, you guys had to experience that in order to appreciate each other just a little bit more. And from your person's standpoint, I definitely feel with this awakening, it's like that light bulb moment. It's like, oh my God, I really do have such intense love for this person, meaning you, Aries. And they don't want to lose you. So I feel for those of you who resonate with this, they're willing to be able to offer this cup of love to you. Question is, are you willing to accept it? Because some of you, I feel, are not so open to that, and that's okay. But there are those of you who would be open to reconciliation with your person. the next message. You are the most beautiful person in the world, at least in my world. You are my whole world, my universe, my all. So I really do feel here that it took challenge, it took something painful for them to realize this. And that's where all this happened with that awakening. And it is falling right below that King of Cups. So if they were a knight before, they're coming through as a king now. More mature, more sure of themselves. This particular king ultimately is very tapped into their emotions, very emotionally balanced. He knows what he wants now when it comes to this relationship. He might have been screwing around before, but he's ready to commit and really give his all now. Last one. You are my daily motivation. Your soul, the essence of who you are, inspires me and helps me navigate the path of life. Our love will never die because true love lasts forever. Yeah. This is your romance of a lifetime for some of you guys. Not for everybody, for some of you. Because I feel, because we've got this one message coming through that they're still involved, it's definitely not coming through for everyone. You'll know where you're at when you listen to this. You'll know if it's meant for you or not. Okay, so let's add some lover's oracle here. Angels and spirit guides for Aries for this bonus reading for the first half of May. Definitely lessons to learn here and healing that needs to happen. And that's been coming through in a lot of my readings lately. And this card wants to fly out. And I just ran over it with my chair. Hold on. Oh my gosh. Okay. Close your eyes and tell yourself that you deserve to feel joyful. You can allow joy into your life regardless of the circumstances you currently find yourself in. Clearly, this is a challenging situation. But this is a reminder from the angels, Aries, that joy comes in many forms. Not just in love and romance, just the gift of being able to wake up and greet a brand new day, to just live your life and create something beautiful out of it. You can allow joy to come in during even challenging times. So if that's something that you can do for yourself until you can move forward from this in however way it's meant to play out, that's what's going to continue the healing that's needed here, at least for yourself. And your person needs to do this too. The next card is forgiveness, which is so needed here. Stop focusing your energy on past events, for life is too precious to waste. You create your reality by what you think, dream, and imagine. And ultimately, in order to have full healing of this situation, Aries, there has to be forgiveness. For those of you who have or are still dealing with a person that's involved themselves with a third party, and they might still be with this person, this forgiveness is something that you have to offer yourself for closure, for healing, so that you can move on, so that you can move forward and bring in the right kind of love that's meant for you. Okay? And this is coming through for some of you guys. Give thanks for the blessings of love soon to come your way. Know that you deserve to be and have all that your heart truly desires. I mean, ultimately, it's coming through for all of you, because blessings are coming in, regardless of whether you're going through this challenge or you're on your healing journey and are fully recovered from this experience. It doesn't matter where you're at. Just know that there's more that's coming in. So many blessings that are coming in to bless your life, Aries, and offer you the happiness and the love that you truly deserve. Okay? All right, guys. So let's grab some overall energies from the Love Compass Oracle. This is by Luna Tide Love. And like I've done for the other signs, let's go ahead and get some overall vibe, overall energy for the connection. We'll grab three from here and take whichever one you're guided towards. Communication, good. Quality time, bottom of the deck, look at this. True love again. Yes, receiving a message, spend some time together. They want to reach out, Aries. They want to be able to communicate. There is a need for expression of feelings and the heart in this relationship or connection. Work on communicating and connecting in different ways. Fully connect with this person and let them know how you feel. And when it comes to the individual that you're focused on for this reading, Aries, I feel it's just a matter of time before they do that, to be able to express how they're truly feeling, what's in their heart for you. I mean, it already started off telling you, you're the missing puzzle piece that makes me feel that I'm right where I belong. So they'll reach out to you. Quality time. Spend some time together. This is what they're wanting. More quality time is needed with this person. Put forth extra energy and effort into this relationship. Make time for dates and fun. Take the initiative and try surprising them with a romantic gesture. There's that romantic gesture again. So this could either be you coming forward with this romantic gesture or your person, but it's here. In however way it presents itself, it's here. Here we are again. Another card referring to true love here when it comes to you and this person, Aries. This love is real and true. This is a healthy, emotional, and genuine connection. You are giving and receiving more love in your life. This may pertain to you reaching the vibration of unconditional love, or you are manifesting a high vibrational relationship. Okay, so for some of you, part of the interpretation of that, of course, is this is your person. This is your true love. They see you as the same, and you will have an opportunity to come back together, come back into union. For others who are just wanting to go your separate way and find a different path here, your person is still messing around with this third party and you don't want any part of that. You can fulfill your own wishes and you can certainly manifest this true love coming into your life. It has the capability of coming in for you. All right, guys. So let's add to this. I wanted to grab some insight from my Journey of Love deck. Let me just grab that really quick. Okay. Angels and spirit guides for Aries for this bonus reading for whoever needs it. What does your Journey of Love look like here? We'll grab a few, take which one you're guided towards. For you, Aries. Oh my, look at that. I love you. Nostalgia. They're feeling very nostalgic about the connection. This could be you too, Aries. The number six could also play a significant role here for you and your person. Could be the month of June for some of you guys. They're telling you right here, I love you. Look at this next message. Duality, can we kiss and make up? I think they want to definitely make up. Baby, making sex right there. So the question is here, Aries, are you willing to kiss and make up? The next message, protection. I just want to keep you safe and warm. They want to be able to protect you, protect this relationship, this love, and they enjoy being with you, the intimacy, safe in your arms, or you feel safe in theirs. Last one. Look at that. eternally yours. Eternity. The number 47 could also play a part here for some of you guys. Or is that a 1? Sorry. It's either 41 or 47. If either of those numbers are significant for you. But yeah, they want to be yours. They want to be your life partner here, Aries. They're coming through here straight up. It's like, I love you. You're my true love. I want to come back. I want to fix this. I want to have babies with you. I want us to heal and fix the damage that was caused by all the drama that this third party brought in. They still want you. Telling you. All right, guys, so let's close this out with some final messages from the guardian angels for you. Angels and spirit guides, please, for Aries, for this bonus reading, for whoever needs it. What is it that spirit wants to leave you with for this bonus reading? Okay, let me grab the bottom of the deck here. Okay, I see two prayers. And then we've got this gratitude card coming through. Thank you. This is a heartfelt thanks to you from someone you recently helped in some way. I, your guardian angel, also wish to thank you for the unconditional love you emanate to the earth, humanity, and those around you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. You are eternally blessed. May peace, grace, and love forever guide you along your sacred path. You know, with everything going on with the pandemic right now and those who are in the front lines and are just doing everything possible to keep us safe and take care of us, I can't help but that from this particular message, this is coming through for some of you guys who might resonate with that. It's a thank you from the people that you've helped in your life. If you happen to resonate with that, of course, or this is just coming from a place of gratitude for those that you have extended yourself towards. And not just necessarily in your love life, just people, friends, family, your tribe. They're coming through here thanking you for that good heart of yours. You are eternally blessed, which is perhaps why you've got two prayers coming through here. Dear guardian angel, help me to believe that all is possible through love. Help me manifest my dreams and live an inspiring and fulfilling life. Help me to feel God's presence in every moment. Help me feel eternally loved. Thank you for being always by my side. What a beautiful message. So your guardian angels, your spirit guides definitely with you. Last one. Dear guardian angel, help me to be flexible in my attitudes and beliefs. Help me not to fear the transient nature of life. Help me to remember the eternal light which emanates from my soul and the eternal light which emanates from the heart of every living thing. Help me to remember that I am eternally guided and loved by God and all creation. You know, and sometimes we forget that. We forget that we are blessed in so many ways. We forget that we are eternally guided towards a particular path. We forget that we do represent the light in people, especially when they are in a dark place. And I feel for those of you who are resonating with this reading, your person, especially if they are the individual that contributed to this tower moment coming down, they brought this darkness onto this situation, and you represent the light that'll get you guys out of that darkness. So if you're open to it, if your heart is open to bringing this person back into your life, I certainly feel that they'll be coming towards you with the right intentions this time around. The love is real. The love is here. They still want to build a life with you. They want to build this tribe with you if you guys haven't already started with that. Healing is quite prominent here. That needs to happen first and foremost. But a part of the journey here for you and this person, Aries, is to find love again, to be able to rebuild the union and have a reconciliation, to be able to make each other's wish come true moving forward. It looks good. Yes, there are some challenges here, but ultimately, you guys can overcome this. The desire to overcome this, it's here. All right, guys, so that's where I'm going to leave it. I do hope whatever part of this resonated with you, that it helped you out in however way you needed it right now. And I'll be back real soon, guys, with more readings for you. In the meantime, take care of yourselves, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.